दिस इज 10th स्टैंडर्ड इंग्लिश 2.2 द थ्री क्वेश्चंस बाय लियो टॉल्स्टॉय 1828 टू 1910. नाउ दिस लेसन इज अ पैराबल. लियो टॉल्स्टॉय वॉज अ रशियन राइटर हु इज रिगार्डेड एज वन ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट ऑथर्स ऑफ ऑल टाइम एंड ही फर्स्ट अचीव लिटरेरी अक्लेम in his 20s with his semi-autobiographical trilogy Childhood, Boyhood and Youth. Now parable is a short story with a moral lesson, and parable usually has human characters. Now in this lesson the characters which are there, main characters, king is there and hermit. Okay, now what happened is, as per the story, once a king had an idea. If he always knew what is the right time to begin every action or for every action, then who were the right people to listen, and what was the most important occupation or what was the most important thing to do. Now this, he got an idea of asking the questions, and he was knowing that he was very much good in or right in thinking. That's why he made a proclamation. Now proclamation means what? It is a declaration, announcement, royal announcement. King made a proclamation in his kingdom, and what proclamation he made? That whoever, he would give a great reward to anyone who would teach him what the right time was for every action, who the most necessary people, like that. So this were the things that he asked for, and he demanded the answers. So he was expecting that the people will come to him and give the answers for these questions, and if he is convinced with their answers, he will give them a good reward. So many learned people, they came to him, but they gave different answers to the king. So some of them, they said that for the reply of the first question, some said that to know the right time for every action, one must draw up. In reply to every first question, some said that to know the first right time for every action, one must draw up in advance a table of days, months and years, and must live strictly according to it. Others declared that it was impossible to decide beforehand the right time for every action, but that not letting oneself be absorbed in idle pastimes, one should always attend to all that was going on, and then to that was most essential. Yet others said that it was impossible for one man to decide correctly the right time for every action, and the king should instead have a council of wise people who would help him to fix the proper time for everything. Now, so equally were varied were the answers for the second questions also. Some said that the king most needed were his counselors, others the priest, others the doctors, while some said the warriors were the most necessary. Then to the third question, about what was the most important occupation, some replied that the most important thing in the world was science. Others said it was skill in warfare. Others again that it was religious worship. The king was convinced by none of these answers and gave the reward to none. That after listening and hearing to all of these replies, king was not convinced by any of the answers, and so he did not give any reward to anybody. Okay, so instead, what happened? Instead, the king was not convinced by the answer, so he decided to go to a hermit who was widely renowned for his wisdom. He was well known for his wise, wisdom, cleverness. That hermit was very much clever, wise, and where he was living, he lived in a small hut in a forest and spoke only to common folk. Common folk means only common people. But king decided to go to this hermit who was very much famous in his kingdom, and he was knowing that king was having some of the assumptions that he will get some good reply and good answer from this wise person. And king went to him and he said that he asked first question. When he went there, he saw that the hermit was very much busy in his work, and he didn't he was continuously digging the ground. And what happened to this king, as he was knowing that he'll not meet me in his royal attire. So what king did, he disguised himself, he changed himself as a poor person. He clothed himself, and he dressed himself like a common man. And then he went to him and he saw that he was busy doing what? He was busy doing his work. And when he went there, he asked to him that he greeted, hermit greeted king, because he was, by looking at him, he was looking like a common man. So he asked, king asked to him, what questions? Now see, how can I learn to do the right time at the right, right thing at the right time? Then, who are the people I most need, and to whom should I pay most attention? What affairs are the most important and need my first attention? Now here he was very much clear about his objective, that what I should ask, and in a very straightforward manner he asked that hermit, because he was knowing that king was knowing that hermit is not a ordinary person, he is a wise person, and I should not use any such words, or I should not be confused enough to ask the questions. So he was very clear in his asking manner. So very first thing that he asked, how can I learn to do the right time at the right thing at the right time? So here what he said, he was very much convinced that the answers I will get from this hermit. Now what happened? Let's see in the story. Hermit listened to the king but said nothing. He just spat on his hand and resumed digging. The king watched in silence for a while, then feeling sorry for hermit, he said, "You are tired. Let me take the spade and work a while for you." The hermit silently handed over the spade and sat down on the ground. When he had dug two beds, the king stopped and repeated his questions. The hermit again gave no answer but rose, stretched out his hand for the spade and said, "Now rest a while and let me work a bit." But the king did not give him the spade and continued to dig. Now what happened? Here the king saw him digging the ground and he felt a little bit sympathy for this old person. And then what happened? He took that spade in his hand and he helped him. Yes. Then after a time, again he asked the same question. So at that time, what happened? He said that the hermit said, "Now you rest and I will work." But instead of giving the spade, what happened? The king continued to do the thing that he was doing, that is, he was digging. Now after 1 hour passed, and another time was going, running. The sun began to sink behind the trees, and king at last stuck the spade into the ground and said, "I came to you, wise one, for an answer to my questions. If you can give me none, please say so." So king was tired now. It was about evening time and there was no reply for his questions. So he said, he requested, "Please, I have come to you to get the answers, and if you are not giving me, or you are not willing to give, please tell me that, and I will go home." Now what happened at that time? Someone, here comes Someone running said, "Hermit, let us see who it is." So at that time, what happened? The hermit attention went where? Towards one of the, someone was running towards them, towards their hut. The king turned round and saw a bearded man and coming running out of the forest. The man held his stomach, pressed against his stomach. Now he was holding his stomach very tightly and blood was flowing from them. He was wounded man. And when he reached the king, he fainted and fell down to the ground mourning feebly. Now this was the condition of that man was totally bad and he was hurt. The king and the hermit, what they did, they tried to help him out. They tried to, they saw that there was a large wound in the stomach. And the king washed it and bandaged it with his handkerchief and a towel the hermit had. But the blood was not flowing. It was not stopping. It was continuously flowing from the wound. And king, he took care of it again and again. He removed the bandage and soaked with warm blood and washed the rebandage it. And every time he was helping, at last, the blood stopped coming out of the wound. And what happened? The king bought a fresh water and gave it to him. Afterwards, when the sun had set, it was all cool. What happened? The hermit, with the help of hermit's help, they carried the wounded man into the hut. Now the man lay there quietly and the eyes closed. He was totally out of his energy. And king was so tired after the work, after this work he had done. And he also fell asleep. Now in the morning when he was awoke, it took his time to remember where he was and who the strange bearded man lying by his side gazing intently at him. So it happens when you are at a new place, so it takes time for you to recollect immediately when you get up from the sleep. So same thing happened here. He found that man sleeping next to him. What that man said, forgive me means please do what you forgive me. What he was knowing that he is a king, and that's why he begged for his deed. Now king was not aware of the deed, but he was knowing that what he had done, and very weak voice he said that, please, I am sorry for you this deed. And king was not able to get what he is saying. So he said that, I do not know you and I am nothing to forgive you for, said the king. So why I should, I don't know you and you do not know me, but I know you and I am that enemy of yours who sought revenge himself on you because you executed my brother and seized his property. So he had a revenge in his heart. And with his motive to end up the king's life, to do